All right, today is Sunday, I think it's March 2nd, and just giving an update on the building of the Wago 1, it's roughly 16-foot, Sam Devlin designed snow goose duck boat. And what I'm showing here, what I've been doing, is the top decking is getting closer. This has approximately six layers of West Systems epoxy, just clear epoxy with 207 special clear hardener on the decks. And the decking has been dyed with a Fedez red mahogany wood dye, allowed to dry. There's fiberglass on there. It's 4 ounce fiberglass because it's a bright finish application. We don't want the weave to show. And then six coats of epoxy were applied at various times to achieve a final built-up coat. What I'm doing now is I am starting the process of wet sanding this epoxy, the purpose of which is to create a final fared surface on which varnish will be applied. And the process that I'm using is I'm just using this. This is actually a 320 grit wet dry sandpaper that I have over a cardboard, just a folded up piece of cardboard, and it's just duct taped on the back. It's kind of it's a silly looking contrivance, but it works. And the reason is it has just enough give. It's relatively hard, but it has just enough give to give me enough the ability to put some pressure down, but not to you know, really create any kind of indentations or anything like that. We might get with a wood backer board. And it seems to be working okay. It is taking quite a bit of elbow grease, I have to admit. And you can see that in the middle section here, ignore that shininess for a moment. In the middle section, this is very, very smooth. So it's very smooth, it's uniform. There are a couple of tiny little ripples in there. But for the most part, it's pretty smooth and the scratch pattern is uniform. And that's what I'm trying to, you know, achieve. Over here in this area, you can see there's a whole bunch of dimpling that's going on, and it's because it's just not fared yet. I have to keep going on that. One of the things that I found is on the very edge in this area, you can kind of see if the camera will focus. I don't know if it will. But you can kind of see on the edge here that you can see some of the cloth kind of coming through. I'm not 100% sure why that is. It could be that there's a little bit of bubbling happening right along the edge and that sort of thing. It's not perfectly squared. And so what I did, I wanted to see how that actually comes across, or if it comes across, when varnish is actually applied. So, you know, will a varnish coat actually hide a little bit of that? So what I did is I did a real brief test of some Epifanes varnish. Just a note on that, I actually asked a rep, and they did pronounce it Epifanes, not Epifanes. And I applied some of that varnish, thinned down, just a real light, obviously a tiny area and application, just to see what kind of a finish that provided, and also if it concealed that issue that I saw. Will it hide this kind of a stippling that's happening in the cloth edge? And what I'm seeing so far, I just put down this little tiny bit of varnish here, and yeah, it kind of hides it real nice. So it creates a shiny surface, but what's more, and I'm not 100% sure why, my belief is that there's some very, very fine you know, pin-like holes that are happening in that area where the epoxy there's just some stippling essentially, and I think what's happening is that the varnish is filling that stippling just a bit. And so it's smoothing it out, and you really can't see the weave anymore. Hard to tell on this image. You can kind of see it there, but you can't really see any weave over on this edge, unlike on the untreated surface, where you certainly can see a whole bunch of that. Now, hopefully, that doesn't come back and bite me later on, after it's been exposed to the sun and all that kind of goodness. I'm sure it will. But for now, I'm encouraged in that it looks like once the varnish is applied, it hides some of that imperfection just enough. So that's an encouraging development. And what I'll have to do is allow this varnish to dry and sand it off again and continue the process of wet dry, or just wet sanding, this decking. It's taking quite a bit longer than I anticipated. So just this area I've been at it for about an hour or so, and quite a bit of elbow grease, which is fine, but you know, it's just another part of the process that adds a little bit more time than I believe might be the case if I was priming and painting the top decks. But again, that's kind of an encouraging development right now. So the application of a tiny bit of test varnish seems to hide some of the imperfections here. We'll see how it is when it actually dries up. But kind of keep plowing ahead with the wet sanding, and more to report later on.